Okay, the question is about different kind of prophecies. How do we discern? I know that on the internet there are all kinds of prophecies, saying what's going to happen this year, next year, Jesus is going to come back soon. All these kind of prophecies. You know, I always would discern. I would not take it. Whatever they say, I will not take it right away. Or some people said to me, prophesy to me. I will not take it as from God. I will discern whether this is from God or not from God. I will say this. Now, if it's people around us, there are some people who pray and they say, oh, Jesus said something's going to happen. We need to do this, we need to do that. My belief is that the Bible says that in Psalm 27, he who fears the Lord, the Lord will guide him in his path. That God will guide us. And also in Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 and 6, it talks about, you know, that in everything that trusts the Lord, do not rely on your own wisdom, and God will guide you. So the Bible has promised that. So, now, I want to tell you, I believe there are prophets. There are good prophets. There are people who prophesy to me that is very accurate. I have seen that. But I also saw some people who prophesied, you know, falsely, and it didn't come true. So for me, I always discern. I would not take it as face value. Especially people, they always say, this sign, that sign. I will tell them. Jesus tells us to do evangelism, to raise up people's spiritual life, and we prepare for the end of the world. It doesn't matter if it is this year, next year, the year after that. It doesn't matter. Even if Jesus is going to come back this month or next year, I'm not going to sell my property and go somewhere else. It doesn't help, right? It doesn't help. So many people say, Jesus is coming back, so sell your property and go away. It doesn't help. If Jesus comes back, I will do evangelism. That is the main thing. So anything like that, we discern with the Bible, and we know that some of them is not true. And if God really wants to say something to us, He is going to come back soon. He will speak to more than one person. He will speak to different people. If you are a God-fearing Christian, God will speak to you too. God will guide you. So I would not rely on prophecy. It will be a reference to me, but not absolute. I won't obey it absolutely. Unless, if I receive it from God and I discern it, and I become very sure that it came from God. Also, so whenever I meet people who said, I hear from the Lord, I have this prophecy, I will always encourage them to take care of problems in their life. Have a close relationship with the Lord and take care of different problems so they can hear accurately. So many people, when they prophesy, they think of raising their status high. I'm a prophet. I can prophesy something special. And it becomes pride. It doesn't work. You know, most important thing is for us is to be humble, to love the Lord, to be concerned about the Great Commission. I always see that the Great Commission is the center of our goal. When Christians don't have that goal, they'll be lost. The goal of Christianity, Jesus sent us to go and preach the gospel and teach them to obey everything He has taught us. So I would see that as most important. It's not to escape suffering. People always say, okay, Jesus is going to come back soon. Escape suffering by selling your property going somewhere else. I would not look for ways to escape suffering, but to look for ways to do evangelism.